I am at my wheelchair appointment. So today we are going to look at measuring my body, because when you get a new wheelchair every 5-6 years, they actually custom make them to your body. So they will, you know, measure my, you know, my shoulders to my hips to my knees, all that kind of stuff. So we'll take you inside and I'll show you. And also I'm hoping I get to pick the colour of my new wheelchair today. What colour will I do? Pink, maybe? Yellow. What do you think? Yellow. I always wanted a yellow one. My first wheelchair I ever got when I was 2, I wanted yellow. They didn't have them available in yellow, so I got a red one. Maybe I'll go red because Alex likes red. We'll see what happens. I'll bring you guys inside. Little one when I was a baby, and then that one maybe when I was older. Yep, I think I've had both of those. Not that one. I've had both of those types, I think.
Oh, did you?
Put up tighter.
Yep.
Without wrecking your skin. Now, both of my T-mars here, so I'm beginning Martin, another technician, to put it on.
Yep.
He'll need to take your chair to the workshop, but he'll need to see the quickie is your next chair. Or a chair called a Thai Light, a different brand.
Because I've always had quickies, haven't I?
Yeah, yeah.
Is there a reason why I've always had quickies, or is it just...
They're really good. The yeah. Thai Lights are a bit, probably a bit stronger, a bit neater.
Okay.
And the Thai Light makes the power control unit, the power assist unit.
On the front.
Which can also fit to a... It's also can also fit on a quickie chair, but it's made for the Thai Light. There's a... What I do is I do a quote for both, because the Thai Light's a bit more expensive, and I think the weight might be a bit less for Steve to lift in and out of the car, so we'll look at those on there. But I need to write all that down, but before I can write it down, I need to get the information from that.
Yeah, and obviously too, it has to like squish down enough that the chair fits and the frame as well, because we've got a frame as well that now has to fit in the car.
Yeah.
So it's not just my chair anymore, and it doesn't matter if it doesn't fold up to really small.
Okay.
But because we've got the frame, and we'll have the frame for quite a while, it needs to be able to, not be too heavy, obviously, that Steve can't lift it, but it also needs to be easily folded and quickly and flat as possible. Because we just went to Melbourne over Christmas holidays, and you know, so we took our car, so we packed everything. So we had like suitcases, we had pram, we had wheelchair, and everything in the back. And like even Hayley was squashed on the side, weren't you?
Yeah.
You and Alex were kind of squashed, and then I had still had things in the front with me sitting in the passenger side.
Yeah.
So it was like, I think, even though his pram's really good, like it folds to pretty much nothing.
Yeah.
But if I got a big chunky chair,
that's
the only problem is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what you'd need to, well, the Thai Light or the Quickie 2 won't make any difference to the bulk of the chair.
Okay.
Except the Thai Light might be a little bit lighter.
Okay. Hello.
Yeah.
Speaking of husband.
Oh, here he is. Here they are. And we're also, I think we should actually put it forward.
I'm not handed my seat, so it's okay with you on that side. Yep, my new seat. Yay, I get a new seat too. Look, cool, because I'm kind of running out of new seats now. It was when Alex was born.
No, please.
He actually had a car accident. Apparently he had a heart attack.
At the wheel.
Oh, wow.
At the wheel and crashed into a big pole and
Mommy's uncle.
Uncle Jack.
Wow.
Yeah, apparently he had a bit of a heart attack, I think, before that as well. He was walking the dogs.
Oh,
and he got really sick, so went home and had to go somewhere.
Would it make it life difficult for you if that armrest was a bit further forward?
Not really. You moved it forward and it's taken me this long to get used to it. Because you turned it around, remember?
Yeah, that's right. Did this get in the way? You put the spooler forward?
No.
Of tables and things? Would that get in the way of tables and things?
That will.
Yeah, that would. Yeah, well,
that will. That's as bad as, yeah.
Okay, well, either
where it is then. Because when I was pregnant, my belly was out to there. Yeah. Further, and that was in.
Okay, now just turn around a little bit the other side.
Oh! That was a big bang. Alex,
sorry, Dr. Boy.
Oh. We went somewhere, was it yesterday? And it was about a 2-year-old, and one of the little boys was crying. Oh. And Alex kind of just looked at him and was like, what? Sunday, yeah. He was like looking at him, he was like, what is that? What is that person doing? That's so funny.
Here, pop that in the bin.
So I'll put it there.
I'm just having a look because I can't see.
Also, it's got an attachment which they make called a smart drive, which which is a little motor that goes out the front, which can be attached to a quickie as well.
If I want
it. And that's if you want it, so that you can actually
push the pram.
Yeah, so that you can use the motor to push yourself, to push, and so that you can, he needs to demonstrate it. You can demonstrate it on your chair. I don't know how to attach though.
Yeah.
But then you can see exactly how it works because I'm not sure exactly how it works.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I'll do a quote for that.
Yeah.
That will.
So how can you have a little
groove? Might make you slide. Thumb. So that's why I want you to try keep the one that you've got and to test this one.
Just to test that one.
But the benefit of this one is you can, you'll still be using that one, your other ones as a backup.
Yeah.
But I want you to try this one because this is what you'll be...
It looks different inside too.
It is. It's a different type of material.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah, I've seen it before.
Oh, it's like... Oh, honey, look. It's not foam.
Yeah.
It's like...
Memory foam.
No, it's plastic.
Plastic.
So,
oh, it's straws.
When you warm up, like when you sit on it for a while, it gets warmer and then it gets softer.
Softer.
So you'll form a well where you're sitting. Okay.
Yeah.
Now.
But it's like straws. Look at it.
Feels
you put it
really
in this,
mm-hmm.
and you put it in the washing machine.
Okay, I was going to wash one.
Laundry bag?
Okay, I was wondering how I was going to wash that. I'm like, because it's going to get in the holes.
Yep, that's right.
Your
laundry bag.
It feels
okay.
So good.
This is your
care
instructions.
Really cool. I love it. It's pretty colour too.
In a gentle cycle.
Mm-hmm. Listening, Stephen?
Yeah, sorry, I'm feeding Alex.
Yeah.
Gentle cycle.
Gentle cycle.
Oh,
yeah. That's right. And
because you're the one that does the washing.
You wash the cover separately.
Okay.
So this is the cover?
Yep.
Okay.
So it's basically like our other one. Except it's got that on it.
Yeah, it's got
that's the difference. Yeah. That might actually velcro better than the other one I've got.
It's in the bottom.
Yeah, no, it's like gel
so
on the bottom.
What I need to do is I need to number that, which I can do first thing we do is take your chair to the workshop.
Yeah.
Okay.
Workshop?
Down the corner. Yep.
No, we're going to visit there.
No.
Witches.
The witches go for a visit to the workshop. God, my chair is so old. Look at it.
How old is it?
I think we worked out 5 years or 6 years since I've had a new one.
Was that
longer
your second
that.
One? Was that your second one?
No.
Is this your fourth one?
No, I've had lots. Ask Joyce after, she'll be able to tell you how many I've had.
Okay.
I've had wheelchairs since I was two.
Wow.
So I think I've had 6 wheelchairs. I'm going to have to ask Joyce. I don't know. She'll know. She'll have all pieces of paper.
Yeah.
From all my appointments. Hopefully today.
I can do that. I can hold the spoon in my mouth and no hands.
Alex is having lunch, or you just had lunch, haven't you?
Yeah.
Oh, Alex scratched me on the neck again. Just waiting. The wheelchair's gone where?
To the workshop.
To the workshop to have some work done on, I don't know what, but.
To workshop.
I don't know.
Bit of routine maintenance, have that seatbelt put on.
Yeah, have a new seatbelt put on. Fixed my foot plate, finally. Ow, this wall is really hard on my back. Oh, that hurts so bad. And put cushion, I think, behind my back. Put a pillow behind my back.
Yupa.
Is he alright?
Yeah, he's smiling. Yupa.
my dirty up cushion. And there's my new one. Looks so much better.
Mm-hmm.
My poor old one.
And then I'm just lying on the bed.
Or sitting on the bed, should I say. Paddy's feet. And there's Daddy and Alex.
That's much better. Thanks, honey. Oh, that hurt my back really bad. Oh. I've got a nice cushion behind our back now, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
That wall's really hard. Come on, Jules. Oh, Jules is back. But my wheelchair's still missing.
If possible,
mm-hmm.
provide pressure relief.
Yes.
Accommodate your joint limitations.
Yes.
Do you get any pain with your back at the moment?
I have been, yeah, just after I had Alex.
Right.
I've had quite a bit of pain in my back.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I don't know whether it was lifting him as he got heavier or it was just like carrying him and then all of a sudden, because I'm not, my back, yeah.
We want to improve your functional level so that you can do more and in and out of the car.
Yes, and picking up somebody off the floor would be good.
Yeah.
And in and out of bed.
Yeah.
Look.
Yeah, no thanks. I've lost a lot of weight since I've had Alex. I'm going to keep it off.
Good.
Big
good
break.
Improve appearance because it'll be new. And,
yes.
And,
I won't have paint on it, won't have scratches on it.
Yeah. What sort of goals do you have for a new chair? Amanda's.
Doesn't faze me.
The same?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty much, is it as long as it folds up, it's light.
Yeah.
Probably no, maybe no handles on it, I don't know. Sometimes he will, like, obviously.
Do you use the push handles at the back?
It's an unconscious thing,
yeah.
But also, too, like, obviously when I was pregnant, in later pregnancy, with Alex, I had no energy, so he was having to push me around.
Yeah.
So, yeah, even if we had ones, if there's ones available that you can, like, take in and out, so if we don't want to have them in.
Push handles.
Yeah. Can we do that?
So why would you not need the push handles? Why would you have them taken off?
I'm just saying, like, so for times that he doesn't want to push me or don't need to be pushed.
Yeah.
Which is hopefully 100% of the time, but there may be some instances where I'd like to be done.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like on Sunday we went to the Botanical Gardens. That's hilly. I can't do that on my own.
Yeah.
So he's having to push me. But most of the time now, he's making me push myself so I get my energy back up from having Alex.
Yep.
So, yeah. And then that might not get in the way of also being...
Trouble is, if you have removable push handles,
mm-hmm.
as soon as you've got removable push handles, you've got extra weight. Because
okay.
you've got extra nuts and bolts to attach them.
Okay.
You've got two sleeves of chewy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
And also you get turning.
Yeah.
Because when they're fixed
mm-hmm.
and you're pushing,
okay.
they're fixed. As soon as you put them in something, then they work themselves loose. So
okay.
it's better to have fixed ones.
Okay.
Yeah,
I just thought I'd ask because I thought, well, if,
That's good, because we need to talk about all those features because I need to write them in a report.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, so you need push handles.
Yes, please.
Yep. And do you use anti-tick wheels? Do you have anti-tick wheels?
No, I don't use them. I don't really like them because when I do get tipped up to go on a curb, they get in the way. So I would, I'd like them because I have a fear of tipping.
Yeah,
when you go up to like a big step,
paranoid.
I know, I'm really paranoid. But if there's like quite a big step, you know, like into people's houses, I can't get up because they get in the way.
Yeah.
I have a few friends and family members that have stairs, and unfortunately, they didn't think about that when they bought the house.
Yeah.
Hopefully my brother's new house is wheelchair friendly.
Do you manage with pneumatic tyres, Steve, or do you want solids?
Solids.
Definitely solids.
Yeah.
Like I've had solids since I was...
Solids are easier to change and rock and puncture.
Yep.
Yeah, they don't puncture.
And do you like the mag wheels or do you want spoke wheels?
Mag wheels would be great, only because spokes, we did talk about this with kids. With Hayley, she used to play with the fingers, and I'm worried about him.
Yeah.
Well, if I can't have bags on my car, I may as well have bags on my chair.
Fucking jet engine installed in a floor.
Is that what you're doing, mate?
A hot rod.
Yeah, put flames on it.
Yeah.
Though on the, I remember the little spoke ones, we used to have like the little beads you could put on them. Remember they used to make noise? Good. I love those. They were fun. But yeah, once I had Hayley, it was like, no, I can't.
Yeah.
Because fingers get caught in them.
Yeah.
And now that we've got out, like she would be fine with it because she wouldn't have it. But with him, because he's a boy, especially they like wheels, I have a feeling his fingers might get caught in my wheels.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I had that when I was a baby.
You did try, yes.
Yeah, yeah.
But I had the main rules when you were a baby. We did that on purpose. So I've just kept them because it's been those two chairs, so we've just kept the main ones.
Yeah.
They're not easy to clean.
You bud.
As you can probably tell by my old chair, but
yeah,
they're practical, so we go with what's practical.
So the back row, you want the same sort, Velcro adjustable, rather than a solid, I think,
it's best to have that in case something happens.
Yeah, I know, but then also too, like if, like I get, you know, you, when I get the new chair, you guys put it to what my back needs. By the time it gets in the car and I go home, the Velcro has come undone. So that's what I was thinking, like it's whether we do just have a back that's suited for me.
And it would be a solid.
That would be solid. I don't have to worry about it, you know, how.
The trouble with a solid with my, one is, is that it's got no give in it, and so you can't lean back into it like you do with the Velcro adjustable, and Steve would have to take it off every time it gets folded.
Okay. Because you know how we were saying with that...
We need to look at whether you need to have a foam insert.
Yeah, with the electric one, you know how I was saying that the support of that with the back and the side pieces, if we had that back piece that was just... Solid.
That's one of the reasons you need an electric wheelchair, because we could put a backrest like that on it. But with your manual wheelchair, you can fold it.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because it would add, and it would add weight.
Weight,
fine. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So, it's just, that would be better for your back if you had a solid back.
Yeah, it would be, definitely. Yeah. Because having to, as every time it goes in the car, the wheel just comes undone, and you have to kind of, because the way my spine is, because I sit crooked, you know how my left side goes to the back, but then on my right side, there's a hole there between my back and the chair, so it looks solid.
Alex!
Oh, hi!
What are you doing?
That's so cute.
Yep.
Come
here. Hey,
Joyce.
Hi.
G'day.
Hello.
Hey, man. How are you going?
Good.
How are you?
Good.
How are you? Not bad.
So, I'll just go and see if I can get Amanda's chair from...
I've been worked on,
The workshop.
Yeah, there's a few things that need to be worked on. So we just put in a new belt for the quilt on it. Can you just, off the cuff, explain the difference between a quilt and a tie light? Other than, so is it, you know, just a neater chair, cost, weight? Yep, that's fine. So you're at a quickie too for quite a while now, haven't you? Yes, I've pretty much had quickie too the whole time, I think. So, Tolite wheelchairs are American built chair as well, so quickies. Basically, a direct rival of each other. But the Tolite ones are just, over the years, have come a fair way, and they're probably a little bit lighter than new quickie twos.
That would be good for him.
Yeah, of course. Quite a few more options, as in your wheels, like lightweight wheels. A lot more options on your casters and stuff like that. All wonderful colours, you know, frame colours,
Colours,
you can get all that type of stuff.
That's my favourite bit. Always has been, picking the colours.
Yeah, so there's some pretty cool colours from Tolite. Yeah, but I'm selling a lot more Tolite wheelchairs now because they're more popular, like just on the web and everything as well, on the internet than the quickies. But yeah, they're the main two I sell. Tolite quickies, but Tolite more than
Tolite sounds good.
Yeah,
we'll give it a go.
Yeah, no, that's fine.
We can do a quote for both.
What's cheaper, quickie or a tight part?
About the same, to be honest.
Okay.
Depends. What? If you're going for super duper lightweight, the tie-up will come out a little bit dearer.
Okay.
It'll be lighter because you can get quickie twos are an aluminium frame. And the You can get an aluminium frame and a tie light, but you can also get a titanium frame and a tie light,
okay.
Which is lighter again. Okay. Titanium's lighter than aluminium.
Yeah, I've got one of those in the back.
Yeah,
titanium rod.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah. So it doesn't rot.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's the good thing about those.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's probably it really, the main difference is on tie light and
cookies. Suck them on your form.
Yeah, okay.
I'm just see how Matt's going.
Yeah.
So we don't have a tie light here.
You
Because your cookie too, there's a folder, in the back of the car.
Yes.
Yeah. I did have an Aero X, which is the aluminium tie light version, but it's out of Milwaukee.
Oh, okay.
I tried to get it before Christmas, but it's still at the guy's house. But I could show it to you, like, that's fine.
Yeah,
doesn't matter whenever I could show it to you.
Yeah, okay.
And the other thing Joyce got me to bring in to show you is a thing called a smart drive. Have you heard of that before?
Yeah, she just explained it to me.
Sounds very high tech.
A couple of minutes ago,
when I come in? Yeah, it is and it isn't. It's basically what it is, it's a power assist device.
Okay.
So.
That looks cool.
What it does.
So cool. Put on your scooter, Hayley.
It's pretty much, and someone's going to do transform it into a scooter.
Yes, power.
Yeah.
So what you do, when your chair comes back, you'll be able to hook it up, and I'll just show you.
Just listen.
This here just pops in here. This is just a brace bar, so I can fit underneath your chair. So this is the motor and the batteries all in one. So basically, once you've got it all set up, you can change the width of this bar. You just pull them on and put it onto the chair, which I'll show you when your chair comes back. And what you end up with once it's all set up, we end up with that and a wristband. And your wristband just goes on left or right, whatever. And you turn them on there, and you turn it on there. And when you push your chair, so you just do a push. You give it about a second and it realises what you're doing and then it'll take off at that speed.
Oh, that's so awesome!
You don't have to keep pushing.
That's can awesome. That speed be maintained or can it be like, say she,
increased?
Say she goes off whoosh and then the smart drive kicks in and just goes whoosh as well.
Yeah, correct.
Can't you, what's the time difference between that speed and slowing down?
What you do, instead of, so it's power assist, so if you do a push, when that's turning, it'll register how fast that push is and it'll just drive it out. If it's too fast, you just tap your wrist and it stops that from driving.
Okay.
Slow it down.
So you get whiplash.
It's not super fast. It just depends how much you put in. If you really want to get going, you can.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
Awesome.
Where do you want this, man?
Yeah. Relying on that to do your turn.
Yeah.
And then when you want to stop, you just tap your wrist.
Yeah, awesome.
And why it's a tap, because your hands are always going back to your push rims.
Yeah.
So you tap.
So you tap on it.
Yeah, it's just like grabbing your push rims.
Yeah.
Did you want to have a try one?
Yeah, I'll have a go.
I mean, maybe I've got to chat about something else on your chair.
Outside, that's all right. Outside?
No, I'm just going around here in a bit.
We're playing here first. Do you want to chat about the chair before I put this on, Joyce? What's the plan?
The reason, so this is in the process of having a new seatbelt for night. But I just brought it back from the workshop so that we can put Amanda in it and we can talk about
it's so old.
The forks and the forks. We'll do that first. Yeah,
it's not a toy.
No. It's a very, very expensive piece of equipment.
It's cool though.
It's got to walk over a driveway.
Yeah, just like a normal.
Rocks.
Yeah, it comes with loose rocks. Like, you've got your driveway, but there's like gravel road, and a lot of rocks get sweeped over.
Oh, yeah.
Will that interfere with the running of that?
Yeah, they're all right on a gravel path if it's made out of gravel, like the whole path is a nice gravel path. But if, like you say, if it's a bit of gravel up on bitumen, it'll just skid, it'll just kick the rocks around.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I'll just go the long way to the bus stop.
Yeah.
And the long way home.
See, and then same thing again, if you were going down off from a footpath onto the side of the road.
Like we've been trying to, because he said he's going back to work, we've been trying to test me, crossing the road with him.
Yep.
And I can do it, I can push myself with my hand and hold his pram with my hand, but when it comes to going down onto a curb and up onto the road, I just can't propel myself that way. So I wonder if that would give me enough momentum to get me over and to push him forward.
Yeah, it's still,
I wonder.
It'll be interesting, yeah, you'd have to really give it a go because
that's my problem. Like, it's not, you know, going along, you know, a normal path on the side of the road. It's,
it's having to cross. It's a bit of dropping down off,
having to cross the road and things like that. So, if we can solve that problem.
Yeah.
How about handle small inclines?
Hey.
How about handle small inclines?
Downhill?
Yeah, downhill, uphill.
Downhill, you just turn it off.
Yeah.
It's the safest option, just tap and turn it off. Because if you're going down too quick, it'll notice how fast you're going, just want to keep drawing you that.
But that would be fun.
It'll only go up to the maximum of 6. It's not super duper fast, but inclines are the same, so if you're going up a hill, you'll do one push or another push to get a bit quicker, wait for it to kick in, and then just let it drive up the hill.
So it'll drive itself up the hill?
Yeah, and you can... The way you turn,
the botanical garden.
The way you turn with them, so you'll, let's just say you're heading out here, you do a push and let it drive, and if you want to turn left or right, you just squeeze your left pusher in for a left.
Wow.
You just keep it, you can keep it down.
Okay.
Yeah,
so how...
You need new wheels as well when you have
one
in there?
Oh, they do wear out eventually. So these wheels...
Oh, new push rings, different push rings?
No. Depends.
That's just
a
unit on the side.
So whereabouts would that sit? Say for argument's sake, that's a new wheelchair right there. Where would it sit?
Oh, it's at the back. I thought it would be at the front.
Sits in there.
Okay.
I have to adjust it. Just sits there like on your axles,
So
if you drop off a curb, it'll lift up and then drop back down. So,
And detachable at any time?
Yeah, you can take it off. Just all you do is just pull that and lift it straight off.
Yeah.
And then wheels roll that way as well. So if you do a turn, there's no resistance.
That's definitely adaptable,
How long have these been available for? Like, are they a new...
Probably been on the market now. The first original one, the battery slid underneath the seat. This MX2, the batteries are in the one unit, so it makes it a lot neater. Probably been on the market for 3 or 4 years now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but that's so cool. This one's probably been on the market for probably 18 months, the newer one.
Oh, okay.
Let's
hope we've got adjustability out.
My new seatbelt and my new cushion. Looks very industrial with that seatbelt.
On that side, neat. But usually we have this adjustable and we loop this back in.
Yeah, when I've seen that adjustable there.
Yeah, so as long as that's enough.
Yeah,
so we'll see how we go.
Looks like one of those aeroplane ones.
Okay.
Doesn't it? That thing was so awesome. What was it called?
Smart Drive.
Smart Drive. Thank you. I keep forgetting. That was so cool. If I had hands free, I would have videoed me doing it, but it was that little black machine. It was fun. I want one.
Now, I just need to ask you some more questions.
Yes. There's only a tiny little lip at the front door.
Level or a ramp at the front?
No, just level. Just a tiny little lip at the front door, but that's about it, isn't it? Yeah.
So the lips really that you need are when you get out down the drive onto the street? Is that your first one?
Yeah. It's just crossing the roads. Like, some of them have those little yellow grates.
Yeah.
That has the little circles on them.
Yeah.
But not every. Yeah.
Yeah.
Do they have not every curb?
No.
I don't know why. Only some of them the Huon Valley Council's decided to put on. Not all of them.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna try and get that fixed hopefully.
Yeah.
And get them to.
You can ring them up.
Yeah.
Or
I've complained.
On their website.
I've complained so many times. Ooh. Haven't I? Because it's not just me in the chair, it's not young people in the chair, but it's older people.
Exactly.
Like, they might have a scooter and it might be a bit easier, but it's still a pain. And then, because people, the worst thing is outside our place, like, not right outside, it's almost next door, where they've got that little lip that I can go down that is the wheelchair access.
Yep.
They've just put a yellow line at the end of last year? Was it end last year? Mid last year, they put a yellow line so that no cars could obviously park there. Yeah, people still park there, and that's the only way I can get to the doctors, get to Woolies, go down to work to see Mum, get to the bank.
Yeah.
anywhere in Hume Valley, like in the main road, that's got all the shops and stuff. I can't get there if someone's parked there.
Yeah.
They don't care. They just park there whether they want to or not.
Yeah.
Because
the police.
Yeah, I do. I do.
We used to have a police officer next door. He said the worst thing they could do is probably give them a ticket, but that's it.
Yeah.
But then the thing is, the person, by the time you bring the police or whoever and told them, but don't do what they say. By the time they come, that person might be gone because they might just be visiting the doctor or they might just be visiting someone up the road.
Yeah. Yeah.
But they don't think. Like, there's clearly a yellow line. You can see it there. There's other ones around here who no one else parks there, but mine, for some reason, because it's right across from the doctor, the doctor's car park fills up really quickly.
Yeah.
So that's why they park there.
So they park there.
Yeah. Have you had pressure areas on the bottom at all?
No, never.
Well done.
On my bottom?
Only on your foot?
Only on my foot for some reason.
Only one foot?
I've had one on the top of my right foot, but that wasn't to do with a pressure. That was more the lymphedema.
Sure. Yeah.
And for me, I wouldn't say it's a pressure. It's more,
Do you need any help with anyone in terms of advocacy to help you get funding? Have you got
Gateway? Yeah, we used to, but we're not at the moment because I was pregnant with Alex.
Right.
Aptcare was where the last funding came from.
Yeah.
Right, so you need to go to Gateway.
Bapcare would probably give me more because that was quite a few years ago, wasn't it? They funded. It's just that one or both of them I had to stop seeing because I was pregnant, so I couldn't do the job search things, I couldn't do all that type of stuff.
Yeah.
So they've kind of like cut my funding and cut and taken me off their list.
Okay.
So I do need to ring them back and say
Now
that he's born, you know, I can look for a job and that I need help with doing a chair because they don't cost just $6,000 like they used to anymore. The GST goes up every year. So this poor chair is probably now $8,000 a new one. Plus, if I get the other thing,
I may as well get. What's more important, a new chair or the smart drive?
Smart drive.
Probably, I would say a new chair.
I'd say a new chair.
And then I can save up for a smart drive.
So I have to write a submission and I have to make it really strong.
If we can get both,
Just put him in it.
Children, I need to get to, I need to do, you know, not, I don't drive, so I walk everywhere. So I have a pram to push, I have an 8-year-old that walks next to me. My husband works full time.
Have you seen a social worker at all? I did have
a while ago. I think I've still got her number somewhere.
So what I'd need to do is I'd need to ask Helen Forrest to assist them because she'd be the OT that would go and assist you for that. Yeah. Would you like?
Nearly all done.
So the appointment's all done. We were there for, I think it's like nearly 1 o'clock. We arrived at 11, so it's been a while. But Hayley's been so good, so I promised her we could get Macca's on the way home for lunch. Yay! Daddy, you want some Macca's or not? No? Daddy doesn't like Macca's.
No, I hate that stuff.
I know. No, you don't like it that much. Okay, ready? Let's go. Yep, 12:56, so it's 1 o'clock. We've been here for 2 hours.
It's alright, we've got to go to Moonan then.
We do too. Oh, we're going home. That's right, we've got to go to Moonan. Maybe we'll get it in Moonan, Hayley. On Glenorchy.
I could go home now, it just means we've just got to buy the bare essentials at Woolies and go to what's her name tomorrow.
No, it's alright, doesn't matter. Yeah, no, we'll go out to Frills now if you want it.
Because he's been fed. He's done.
Yeah, I know. Macca's! Yay! We haven't had Macca's for ages. No, we did actually.
Sing.
We did.
Sing.
I know, you get a sing toy, maybe. We did actually have Macca's not that long ago.
No, we didn't. In Melbourne. No, we didn't.
Yes.
No, we didn't.
Yes, we did. In Melbourne, remember, with Kylie.
Oh, yes. I thought you were talking about the other time we had Macca's in Melbourne.
No, I don't know. I don't know what you're talking about, honey. Oh, what's going on with this light? Yeah, that'll be good with my new thing for my wheelchair going up and down that hill just there.
Yeah.
How cool would that be?
Cool.
That $900 pram now.
No, we still need it because the axle on the back's wider. So it still fits in my chair so that I can, the front wheels of my chair, so that I can grab onto it.
Well, that's alright.
So.
You're lucky.
Well, it wasn't $900 actually, it was only
$700. Oh, it was close enough. It was $898 actually.
No, it was $700.
No, it was $800.
Anyway.
Oh, whatever.
Let's go grocery shopping and then go to Macca's!
Yay, Macca's!
Yay! It's alright, you don't have to have any.
I'm not having any.
Good.
You can just have a drink.
Yep.
Probably will just get a drink.
Just get a drink and...
It's 9 o'clock already.
Oh. Sweetheart, we're aware of the time. We probably won't be spending long in No Frills anyway.
No, going to No Frills in Milwaukee.